Hello everyone, I'm Shruti Gupta from Koenig Solutions, and in this video I am going to discuss how to footprint a target using Multego. Multego is an open source intelligence and forensics application which can help us gather information about a target and represent this information in an easy format. So it's basically, in general, it's a kind of a footprinting tool that is for information gathering and is used to gather a lot of information, maximum possible, for the purpose of hacking, forensics, penetration testing, and so on. It has got a library of transforms for discovery of data from open sources, and visualization of the information is done using a graphical format which is suitable for link analysis and data mining. So let's get started. So for downloading, we can use the Multego CE download. You can just go to Google and write this down, and then you get this. You go to and click this link, so you get this perturba.com's downloads page. So here I have used the CE edition because it's a community edition. It's free and it has got a good amount of options. Accordingly, you can choose the one you want. So here you can see we have different operating systems. I'm choosing Windows, and here you can see there are different kinds of versions. Usually you need Java with this, so I suggest go with the plus Java 1 in case you don't have it updated. This can help you to get it updated. And accordingly, if your system is 64-bit or 32-bit, take the particular one. And when you click on download, it will start downloading the particular exe file. Now, for this video, I have already got it here. You can see here. So let's click on it. So you can see Multego has got started. You can see it's saying it's a prerequisite Java. Let's click on OK. It wants to install Java. So it will show up. So you can see we have the welcome to Java setup. Let's install it. Is installing Java now. You can see now Java is almost installed and it's done. It will open this successfully installed. Let's close it. It will automatically open the Multego setup. So we have the welcome wizard of the Multego GUI. Let's click on next. So here we have the license agreement. Let's go I agree. Install for everyone. So it's getting installed. It will take a few seconds. So you can see it is done now. Let's go to Multego. You can see it here, this three dot symbol. You have it here. It's loading the modules. It's starting up. So you can see here we can select the product. I am using Multego CE. So here we have the configure Multego welcome screen. So here it's got the login page first, so we'll have to log in. Let's either, if you have already an account, you can just click, write down your email address, password, and login, or you can go here, click on register here. And you'll get this page here. You can use for this for registration. For this video, I have already got it the registered. So I'm using my email ID and password for the same. I'll just solve the captcha. OK. Okay, let's go next. So to register. So you can see it has got the details. Let's go next. Now it will install all the transforms. Transforms here is like a small modules that help us to gather information. So definitely needs to install the transforms so we can use them. So this is one of the most important step. If this is not done properly, we won't be able to use Martego properly. Also, Martego is inbuilt in Linux, also Kali Linux versions. In some of the previous versions of Kali Linux, if you open Martego, it causes issues sometimes by the registration procedure. So, but in the newest version of Kali Linux 2017, it works well. So you can use from there also. Let's go next. I'm using the blank graph. It will help me do more customization and have a look at Martego more deeply. Let's let it open. So you can see it's opening a graph. Graph here means like a plain area where we can work out. In some cases, in case it doesn't work, or if you by mistake put on some other option, you can go to this button. It will open a new graph. Now, how do you use this is, basically, you have to know something about the particular target, like whatever you know. Suppose I know my target is a website. I know a website about the target, let's say. So I can go here on the left side. Here you can see a lot of infrastructure. So whatever you know, take that infrastructure, like I know a website. So you take this and you drag it to the main screen. You can see it has been dragged. It has been dragged. Yeah, I have dragged this website. Now I'll just replace Petarva.com with my target. I'm using certifiedhacker.com here, which is a legal site for hacking. Okay, now I have got what I knew about the target. Now I'll try run transforms on it. For example, let's try all transforms. Let's say server technologies. So you can see we have got this output transform output window. It's trying to run the transform. So you can see it shows done here with 12 entries. I can see here the 12 entities now. So it has shown me it is using all these jQuery, JavaScript, XHTML, UTF-8, all of these things in here. If you want to see particular things, or you want to, you know, see all the things, all the shapes in here, you can see from this overview window. You can try to move this to see all of it also. Okay. Now, similarly, we can you put on many transforms. As many transforms as you like, you can try. Some may give you results, some may not give you results. So, you can put in transforms on the particular things that you have got, or from the main parent thing also. For example, let's say I am trying another transform. Let's say I'm already in all transform. Let's say to domains. So it's running now. You can see here, running the transform. It's done. It got two entries. See, we have something on the end. So you can see certifiedhacker.com. If I want, I can try to run on this also something. Let's say startup authority details. So it's running another transform. You can see I've got some details. Yes, these are the two. These are the name server, and this is another bluehost.com. So similarly, I can keep on going on with various transforms, and it will keep on showing me information. I can try to maybe go in here and do some other transform. So randomly keep trying various transforms, and it will keep giving you information. I've got an IP address. So this is how you can just play around with Martego, and it will be giving you more and more information as you go with different transforms. I hope this video will help everyone to have a good head start with Martego. A brief introduction to it, and then as you play around, you get more and more accustomed to it and you understand it more. This is how Martego works. Thank you.